Okay, now we're going to turn to the main theme of the course, which is using diagonalization to solve problems. So in particular, evolution problems. So suppose we have, difference equations. A difference equation is where you're given the value of some variables today as a function of the values of those variables yesterday. So we'll say, in this example, we'll say that x1 today is 3 times x2 yesterday, and x2 today is twice x1 yesterday plus x2 yesterday. Now, of course, and we want to have some initial conditions. x1 and x2 start with 6 and 1. And you can probably think of some hokey word problem that this might fit, but let's just look at the equations. So, in terms of matrices, we're saying we want to solve x of n is this matrix times x of n minus 1, we'll call the matrix A, and we had the initial condition 6, 1. Now, whenever you've got a problem of the sort x today is a matrix times x yesterday, the strategy is the same. The strategy is diagonalize the matrix A. So we want to find a basis of eigenvectors of A. In this video, we're going to talk about the case where A is diagonalizable. In the next video, we'll talk about what happens if A isn't diagonalizable. Then we want to pick new coordinates, and the new coordinates are just the coordinates of x in the B basis. So we'll call this basis B. And if you rewrite the equations in terms of the y coordinates, everything will decouple. So solving the equations for the y coordinates is fairly easy, and then at the end of the day you convert everything back to x. So you don't try to go from x at the beginning to x now all in one fell swoop. You first convert to the initial value of y, then the final value of y, and then the final value of x. Okay, so let's do that for a particular example. We have the matrix 0, 3, 2, 1. We can apply our tricks to it. The rows add up to 3. 0 plus 3 is 3, 2 plus 1 is 3, so 3 must be an eigenvalue. And the trace is 1, so the eigenvalues add up to 1. And that means the eigenvalues have to be 3 and negative 2. And then how do you find the eigenvectors? Well, you take A minus lambda times the identity, you row reduce. I'll skip the algebra. The eigenvectors wind up being 1, 1, and 3, negative 2. So, okay, now we got our new coordinates. Y is the coordinates of x in the B basis, which is to say we write x as y1 times the first basis vector plus y2 times the second basis vector. Y is x in the B basis, and you get that by taking x in the E basis and converting over, which is to say x itself, and you convert over. So y is PBEx, and how do you get the change of basis matrices? In one direction it's easy, just the columns are the eigenvectors. The other direction, you take the inverse of the matrix. So we now have our elevators in this diagram. Going up here is PBE, and our down elevator is PEB. Okay, and then we work it out. Y times 0 is just PBE times Y of times X at times 0, and it works out to be 3, 1. Hooray. Okay, now we want to rewrite our equations in terms of Y. So if x at time n is y1 times b1, so y1 at time n times b1 plus y2 at time n times b2, that's supposed to be equal to a times x at time n minus 1. But x at time n minus 1 is y1 at time n minus 1 times b1 plus y2 times n minus 1 times b2, and we multiply by a. But a times b1 is lambda 1b1, and a times b2 is lambda 2b2. So these two things have to be equal. And how can two linear combinations be equal? Since these are linearly independent, this must equal this, and this must equal this. So we get our new equations, which is that y1 at time n is lambda 1 times y1 at time n minus 1. And this example, lambda 1 is 3, so that's 3y1 of n minus 1. And y2 is lambda 2 times y2 yesterday, so it's minus 2 times what we had before. And we see that, lo and behold, it's decoupled. The first equation only involves y1, not y2. The second equation only involves y2 and not y1. Hooray! We know how to solve those equations. Since y1 gets multiplied by 3 every day, after n days, we've multiplied by 3 to the n. And since we started at a value of 3, 3 to the n times 3 is 3 to the n plus 1. y2 is multiplied by negative 2 every day. We started with the value of 1, so negative 2 to the n is times 1 is negative 2 to the n. So, if you will, y at time n is 3 to the n plus 1, negative 2 to the n. Okay, finally we ride the down elevator. We say x at time n is the first coefficient times 1, 1, plus the second coefficient times 3, negative 2. And you work it out, and there it is. Or in general, you could write it as PEB times y at time n. Okay, we solved our problem. So let's look at the general picture of what we did. We rode the up elevator, that was PBE, and then we multiplied each coefficient by lambda to the n. So that's multiplying by d to the n. And then we rode the down elevator, which is PEB. So y of 0 was PBE times x of 0. Y of n was d to the n times y of 0. X of n was PEB times y of n. And if you put them all together, you see that it's PEB d to the n PBE times x of 0. And that is a to the n. Okay. So we could have gone up here and said, oh yeah, every day we're multiplying by the matrix A. And so after n days, we've multiplied by a to the n. The statement that x at time n is a to the n times x at time 0 is completely true. It's also completely useless because you don't know how to figure out what a to the n is unless you diagonalize. To figure out a to the n, you have to write it as p d to the n p inverse. And that's essentially going around our square.